A very good morning, one and all. Welcome to today's classes. We were discussing about growth and development of a school-going child. So in the last class, we have just started with the school-going child and who is a school-going child. And regarding the biological development with height and weight, the formulas also we have discussed. And what is the pattern of change in height and weight? Along with that, we have discussed also like vital signs and also dentition. So in today's class, we will start with the physiological development. So already we were discussing about the maturation of systems in different age groups in infancy, toddlerhood and in preschoolers, how the changes occurs in the maturation of different systems. That is already discussed. And as a continuation, what are the changes happening in a school-going child? So regarding the cardiovascular system, the change which is happening is in the positioning of the heart. So heart assumes more vertical position, just like adult. The vertical positioning is more happening in school-going child comparing to the preschoolers. And it is because of the left ventricular development. Okay, and downward placement of the diaphragm. So these two reasons, downward placement of the diaphragm, so that compression is decreased, some more spacing is available for the heart to get a vertical position. And also one more thing, left ventricular development is also happening during this time. So because of these two reasons, heart assumes more vertical position during the school age. The second system in which some changes are happening is in the nervous system. So by 10 years, nervous system will be completing its maturation. So some changes are also may happen in the future years, but necessarily all functions, all maturation is completing by 10 years of age. And this maturation we can see in the sensory, motor and the cognitive processes. So the sensory sensations will be more perfect, the motor abilities will be more perfect, and also the cognitive processes, mathematical and other abilities, thinking and intellectual abilities, everything will be shown by a child at 10 years onwards. So this shows the maturation of the nervous system. Next is about the gastrointestinal system. So in gastrointestinal system, what happens is maturity of the GI system is reflected in fewer stomach upsets, better maintenance of blood glucose levels. So when we are comparing to a previous year, like in infancy, very frequently the child will get the diseases in GIT and also in respiratory infections are more chances are there. So diarrhea, constipation, these all problems will be more seen in infant and less comparing to infancy we can see in toddlers and we can see in preschoolers. But comparatively, the upsets of GITs will be very less in school or going child. And also the child will be able to manage a blood sugar level even with 3 meals. Okay, so increased stomach capacity. So in a sitting, the child will be able to eat more amount of food to satisfy his needs. So that breakfast, lunch, dinner, with these 3 meals itself, the child will be able to manage properly the blood glucose level. And comparing to the infant, toddlers and preschoolers, in between snacks and frequent feeding may not be required in a school-going child. Then retention of food for longer periods of time. So as we know, the child will be able to have more stomach capacity, and because of that, child will be able to hold more food for a longer period of time. Just comparing to preschooler, toddler or infant. Regarding the urinary system, already we discussed that by 2 years, the urinary system will be getting matured, kidneys will start its functioning maturely. And by school age, the child's bladder capacity increases. ability to hold urine as there, and more amount of urine will be retained by the urinary bladder. So but there will be differences between girls and boys. It will be greater in girls than boys. So this is about the urinary system. So specific gravity, everything is increasing, functioning is more mature, so that we can say that it will be very evident with the smell of the urine, and other test can prove the functioning of the urinary system. Regarding the endocrine system, all functions except those regulating reproduction mature prior to puberty. So this you have to read along with the neurological system. Like all systems, like all endocrine organ, all endocrine glands will be functioning more and well except those of reproduction. Okay, so the nervous system, in nervous system and also in endocrine system, all functioning will be getting matured, but except the reproduction. So the reproductive functioning, the maturation will be completing by adolescent period, and all other endocrine system will be functioning normally as an adult. And physiological control of homeostasis and response to stress gradually increases. So like even in infancy, we have seen that there is homeostasis and other imbalances, electrolyte imbalances, were more chances are there during that age. And these all problems will be resolving by this age regarding the endocrine system. So hope you all are clear with what I am talking about. Next is immune system. So normal adult levels of immunoglobulins are during the school years. So as we have discussed, all the systems are getting matured by school age. In immune system also, all immunoglobulins will get its maximum level, adult levels, by school age. The increased amount of lymphatic tissue in the nasopharynx continues to cause blockage of the eustachian tube. So there are chances of ear and other problems because of the lymphatic tissues in the nasopharynx. Other than that, there will not be any problems in this. And this lymphatic tissue will be helping in, again, it will be protecting our body. And there are certain common sickness in school children, like epistaxis. Epistaxis, that is nasal hemorrhage, then sinusitis, recurrent abdominal pain, appendicitis, allergic disorders, headache, osteomyelitis, and rheumatic fever. So these are the some of the common sicknesses in for which the children may come to hospital for treatment. Okay, and regarding one more thing, that is along with the body proportions, what are the changes in the body proportions? So mouth and jaw become larger. So during this time, mouth and jaw become larger. There will be changes in the forehead, like forehead broadens and flattens. Nose become larger, trunk elongates and becomes slimmer, and abdomen flattens, arms and legs lengthen. So there will be some disproportions in the body of the child. So now mouth and jaw become larger because during this time, more teeth are appearing, and our body, the face is very small, but the mouth will be large. Okay, because it has to occupy the teeth, which has to be there for his lifeline. So that's why mouth and jaw, that portion, mouth with the teeth, that area will be larger comparing to the whole face of the baby. Okay, forehead broadens and flattens. Nose become larger, trunk elongates and becomes slimmer, abdomen flattens, arms and legs lengthen. So these are the some changes in the body proportions of the child. And there are some characteristics of school going child. So this is the ugly duckling stage, we can say. School going child or appearance of the child will be more ugly, because in infancy the child was very cute. And in toddlerhood, even we can tolerate the cuteness, no problem. Like preschoolers, the baby look as gone, but still we can manage. But when the child is becoming a school-going child, it may be the worst time for us in terms of our beauty or our cuteness. So some teeth are missing and all over the child's body, everywhere it will be messy because nobody is there to care for their hygiene. Like they have to manage by themselves. Their hair may be disorganized. Some look will be very ugly comparing to our previous years. Okay, I'm not telling that you will not become beautiful afterwards. When we are comparing the previous years, we were very cute in infant, toddler period and preschool period. But in school going child or school age period, it will be more ugly look will be there for the child. So that's why we can say that the characteristics of a school going child, that is a ugly duckling stage. This is because of this teeth are losing and teeth which are coming is bigger for a small face. So that's the reason for one characteristic, that is ugly duckling stage. The second is quarrelsome age. So child will be quarreling with our own friends, with the parents, with the siblings. So they are trying to get the independence by making quarreling with others. So the child will be quarreling, like especially in schools and other neighborhood, the child will be playing and making quarrels. So this is a quarrelsome age. And another characteristic of school going child or school going age is gang age. Because till this particular age, we were in the home and we don't have any interactions much. But when the child is coming to the school, according to their own interest, they will be making some gangs. Girls will be making girl gangs and the boys will be making gangs with the boys. So this is a gang age. That is, they are making a relationship between the peers. So these are the some of the characteristics and play age. So most of the time they want to engage in play. That is the reason why this is known as the play age. Okay. So characteristics of school going child, that is ugly duckling stage, age, quarrelsome age, gang age and play age. So these are the some of the characteristics of school going age. So hope you all understood the topic what we were discussing. We'll continue in the next video. Thank you.